Hello everybody, so this video is about Sonam Kapoor's traumatic experience in London with Uber. I got interested in the story because I'm an MBA graduate and I've worked with different multinational companies, and one of the companies I worked for was in the automotive field, and we used to get a lot of customer complaints like this. And you know, I have some experience of how to handle customer complaints like this, but this is unique because Sonam Kapoor is a celebrity. So I will just brief you of the whole story of what happened and what I think Sonam Kapoor should do and what I think Uber should do. So she sent this tweet on January 16th at 4 a.m. where she says, "Hey guys, I have had the scariest experience with Uber London. Please be careful. The best and safest is just to use the local public transportation or cabs. I'm super shaken." So then one of the journalists asks her, "What happened, Sonam? As someone who takes cabs in London, it would be good to know." So for that, Sonam Kapoor replies, "The driver was unstable and was yelling and shouting. I was shaken by the end of it." Then Uber gets into the picture and Uber says, "Sorry to hear about this, Sonam. Can you please send us a DM with your email address and mobile so we could look into this?" Then Sonam replies to that tweet saying that, "I tried complaining on your app and just got multiple disconnected replies by bots. You guys need to update your system. The damage is done. There is nothing more you could do." So this is a very, very bad PR for Uber because Sonam Kapoor is a celebrity, a well-known celebrity. So what I think Uber should do is somehow get in touch with Sonam and try to, you know, keep, you know, control the situation before it goes off hand, and make sure that the situation is handled in such a way that Sonam is okay with whatever you're doing. To kind of make her feel good about the fact that you're handling the situation, and then ask her to put out a tweet in support of Uber saying that, "Okay, Uber got in touch with me and they handled the situation and now I feel okay." So that would be a good thing for Uber to do if they are really concerned about the PR that this is going to create. And also, you know, sometimes, and I also think that Uber would not have, you know, given it attention if it was not a celebrity. Let's say, you know, you or me, you know, take a Uber in London and we had the similar experience as Sonam. Do you think Uber would have got in touch with you and asked to rectify the situation? I don't think so. So this is happening only because Sonam is a celebrity. So that tells you a lot about these companies that, you know, they don't take these customer complaints seriously at the first look, unless, you know, it's going to be damaging for their brand. And even in the company that I worked for, we always see what is the credibility of the complaint, and if this, you know, if the customer who's giving this complaint is acting in a rational way or is unreasonable. So a lot of, you know, factors play into it before, you know, taking these complaints seriously. And here I think Uber has taken this complaint seriously only because it's a celebrity, and they know it could be bad for their brand. So with respect to what Sonam can do, I think, you know, she should be open if Uber is trying to get in touch with her, and see what Uber can do. First of all, you know, as she said, it's happened. There's nothing they can do to, you know, get away the trauma that she's gone through that experience, but at least make sure that she feels okay, that she's being given the due diligence in terms of Uber apologizing for the experience and saying that we will take care, make sure that this doesn't happen in the future, something of that sort, so that they make her feel okay about it. So I think Sonam should be open for Uber to get in touch with her and see what best they can do. So yeah, I think, I don't know if this story is going to be trending for a while, but I, as a marketing person, I really thought, you know, I just thought of giving my two cents on it. So anyway, I'm looking forward to meeting all of you in such interesting videos, especially some trending topics like this. Take care.